Coaches and rowers, how often have you heard this? Rowers, sit up straight so you can breathe. Sit up straight, make sure you can get some good air. Very good advice, but it's often misunderstood on the rower. And it starts with one of the three connection points. The three connection points on the rower are seat, feet, and handle. So today we are going to spend a good amount of time on the seat, because when I look at a sea of rowers out there in a workout, this is most often the key indicator that they're not going to enjoy that rowing piece. A lot of times the rower is thrown in a workout to elevate the heart rate, which it can do easily, but if you are short stroking things due to the way you sit on the seat, or you don't have good leg performance due to the way you sit on the seat, then the workout can just be terrible, whether the rower is the beginning, the middle, the end, or all three. So let's head to the rower, sit down on it, show you the good, the bad, and the ugly of how to sit on the seat properly in order to initiate the proper rowing stroke. Let's go. All right, team, here's the rower. And again, the three connection points are going to be your seat, your feet, and your handle. And this is going to be a multi-part series where we cover all three. We started last week with some pointers on how to set up the rower for you, your height, your length, those kinds of things. So if you didn't check that out, please do. Sitting on the seat properly, no matter what rower you have at home or in the gym, is going to be critical for you getting the full length of the stroke for your size and your anatomy. We're going to leverage some collars in order to kind of show you the difference in stroke length as we work through the mistakes and then showing you the proper way to sit on the seat and getting a full stroke. All right, sitting on the seat properly is something easily said, easily demonstrated, and rarely repeated by many CrossFitters and rowers alike. So you sit at your desk all day, you sit in your car, you get used to sitting a certain way. And quite honestly, you kind of want to, you know, listen to your coach and listen to your parents and sit up straight. Everything's in line. You think you're doing yourself a service here. And is you really want to sit with a forward lean and have these shoulders in front of these hips, much like a power position if you were lifting something off the floor. So if you can imagine trying to be straight up and down and lifting something off the floor, it would be very, very difficult. Because these foot stretchers are 45 degrees, you are actually kind of pushing up and then out as you initiate the stroke. Therefore, you want to sit with a forward lean. Some people actually pick up their butt. Some people just kind of sit like they're on a squatty potty or on the toilet. Whatever analogy works for you, you don't want to be on this part of your butt or this part of your butt. The next error we see is people sitting like this. So they've already opened up their hips and de-emphasized their legs. Even sitting straight up, you have less leg power than you would with that forward notion. Again, just like lifting things off the floor. So let me show you a good stroke. Sitting with a forward lean, sometimes it's better to kind of grab these straps, kind of rock yourself into place. That's what kind of works for me. Then get into the catch position. That is the beginning of the stroke. And then start taking your strokes. And I've set these collars on the floor to show you how far this handle is moving with a proper stroke. Now, what we see in the gym many times is somebody sitting straight up And because of the verbal cue of sit up and breathe, they want to just stay straight up. Now look at the handle if I'm just doing that. It's a much shorter stroke. And if you're trying to go fast, which to many people is not push harder, but do more strokes per minute, this means you're going to be in the low 30s, maybe even high 30 strokes per minute. That is going to jack your heart rate up tremendously. That would be the equivalent of having a band around your ankles and somebody telling you to run a 400. Literally, you're short stroking that effort. And then hindsight, if you go ahead and sit on the back of your butt, you maybe hit this mark, but you de-emphasized your legs by opening up your hips from the get-go. Like right when you sat down, you opened your hips were open. And now that de-emphasizes your legs. All right, team, one thing to remember, the rower can be frustrating, probably no different than learning an Olympic movement like the clean or the snatch or maybe even the deadlift. It is a learned movement that no one does right the first time. So it's going to take a little practice. Hope you enjoyed the video today. There's plenty of videos on this channel. If you want some more information about the rowing stroke, common errors, and how to improve, I put up a playlist, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thanks a lot.